Namaste, my dear students. How are you all? I hope every one of you are doing great over there, and I hope everyone is fit and fine over there. Well, students, today we are going to address the students of grade 4, and we are in the subject science. And today's topic is our body and personal hygiene. But before moving on to our topic for today, do you remember what topics did we learn in our previous classes? Well, we had gone for the topics like vertebrates, invertebrates, right? Oviparous and viviparous animals. In the similar way, terrestrial animals, aquatic animals and their characteristics. These were the topics that we had discussed in our previous classes. And I hope all those topics were useful for you. Now, today, we are going to learn personal hygiene, our body and personal hygiene. And in this topic, our body, it is made up of many organs. It is made up of many systems, organs, tissues and cells form our body. Okay, cells, they are the smallest unit of our life. And group of cells, they form tissues. Group of tissues forms organs. And organs, group of organs form systems. And finally, group of systems form a complete human body. Our body, it is divided into mainly three parts. They are head, trunk and limbs. Okay? Head, trunk and limbs. And every one of us, we wish to be a healthy person, and we carry out various activities to conduct to lead a healthy life, isn't it? So what kind of person is called a healthy person then? A person who is physically and mentally fit from all the aspects is called a healthy person. Every one of us, we wish to be a healthy person. And none of us, we would love to fall sick or take rest, isn't it? Every one of us, we love to be a healthy person. And good health makes a person happy and cheerful. A person who is healthy is always happy and cheerful and is loved by all as well. Okay, now let me drag your attention in three major parts of our body, that is head, trunk and limbs. Talking about head, it is the uppermost part of our body. Our head, it consists of various vital organs. Vital means necessary or essential organs, okay, such as brain, eyes, ears, nose, mouth. These all organs are included in head. And the uppermost part of our head is covered by hair. See, the uppermost part of our head is covered by hair, isn't it? So head, it is also one of the very important part of our body, since all the vital organs are located in the head only. Then talking about next part, that is trunk. What do you mean by trunk then? Okay, trunk, it is also the part of our body below the head, but it does not include limbs. Okay, limbs means hands and legs, they are counted as our limbs. So let me repeat it again. Trunk, it is the part of our body below our head, but it does not include hands and legs, that is limbs are not included, as they are not counted as trunk. Understood? That means it is also the biggest part of our body. And also trunk, it consists of various genital organs as well as anus as well. We pass urine through our genital organs, whereas we pass stool through anus. And we must take care of these organs regularly. We must wash and clean these organs regularly. Okay? Now, the third part of our body, that is limbs. As I have already discussed, in trunk, limbs are not included, that is hands, two hands and two legs, they are included in limbs. Limbs, we have two hands, right? And each hand consists of five fingers along with nails. In the similar way, two legs also consist of five toes along with nails. We need to trim and cut the nails, and we need to wash our hands and legs regularly. That is also the way of maintaining personal hygiene. Now, let me drag your attention towards the topic personal hygiene. Personal hygiene. Now, it is made up of two terms, personal and hygiene. What do you mean by personal? Personal means belonging to ourselves. It doesn't belong to someone else, but it belongs to ourselves. That is personal, okay? And the next word, it is hygiene. What is hygiene? Well, let me tell you, it is the study of health. The study of health or the science of health is called hygiene. So, as a whole, personal hygiene. What is personal hygiene? All the activities that we do to maintain good health is called personal hygiene. Okay? The activities that we do to maintain good health is called personal hygiene, or it is also the practice of keeping our body and belongings neat and clean in order to live a healthy life. Personal hygiene, the practice of keeping our body neat and clean in order to live a healthy life. So, we must maintain personal hygiene in order to look smart. In order to be free from diseases, we must maintain personal hygiene. Okay, so why do we need to maintain personal hygiene? Personal hygiene, it is very necessary for us. We must maintain personal hygiene. Maintaining personal hygiene helps us to prevent from various diseases. We'll be safe from many diseases, and also it helps us to develop our personality. We look smart if we maintain personal hygiene. So, maintaining personal hygiene is a must. Okay? Now, students, how can we maintain personal hygiene then? There are various ways by which we can maintain personal hygiene. To maintain personal hygiene, we should take a bath regularly. We should brush our teeth at least twice a day. We should trim our nails. We should clean our hair regularly. We should wear clean clothes. And we should take proper care of our sense organs, eyes, ears, nose, etc. Similarly, we should also wash our hands before and after meal. In the similar way, we should also wash our hands after the use of toilets. And finally, we should use mask, and these days we sanitize our hands also timely, right? Now, I'll be explaining each of these topics in brief, okay? So, the first way by which we can maintain personal hygiene is we should take a bath regularly. We should take a bath regularly to maintain personal hygiene, to remove the dust and germs from our body. When we play or work for a long time, the dust, dirt and germs, they get stuck in our body. And to remove all those dust, dirt and germs, it is very necessary to take a bath. And by what do you use to take bath? We use soap and clean water to take a bath. In the picture also, you can see the babies are enjoying to take a bath, right? And I know you also enjoy taking bath. You also take bath, right? Okay, and after taking bath and before wearing the clothes, we need to wipe our body with a clean towel. It should be wiped up. The water that we use to take bath, it still remains in our body, so that before wearing the clothes, we need to wipe our body with a clean towel. Okay, the second way by which we can maintain personal hygiene is we should brush our teeth regularly and at least twice a day. Okay, brushing our teeth, it helps our teeth to be strong and it also helps us to have a better look. The teeth, it adds beauty to our face, isn't it? So it is very necessary to brush our teeth. We should use soft brush and a good toothpaste to brush our teeth. A soft brush helps to maintain good teeth, but if the toothbrush that we use is not good or it is hard, then what happens? It may hurt our gums. So a good toothbrush and toothpaste must be used to brush our teeth. And as I told, we should brush our teeth at least twice a day. If we do not brush our teeth, then the food particles that we eat get stuck between the cavities of our teeth and it enhances the growth of germs. When the food particles gets rotten inside, then it develops the growth of germs and it hurts as well. So that it's very necessary to brush our teeth at least twice a day. Similarly, we should also clean our hair regularly. It covers the upper part of our head, isn't it? And hair, it must be washed. It must be cleaned regularly. How can we take care of our hair? By washing it regularly. We need to wash our hair regularly by combing the hair, by massaging our hair with the use of mustard oil or coconut oil. And if we do not wash our hair, what happens? It also enhances the growth of dandruff, microbes, and even the growth of lice also. So it's very necessary to wash our hair. Either we use shampoo and a clean water to wash our hair, and also we need to clean our comb our hair with the help of comb. Okay, and similarly, the next way by which we can maintain personal hygiene is by wearing clean clothes. If your clothes are very clean, everyone gets attracted to you. But if your clothes are dirty, then what happens? Everyone, they want to run away from you. Okay? So that wearing clean clothes help us to build our confidence level also. It helps to develop our personality also. And we can get a chance to make many friends as well, isn't it? So in the picture also, you can see there is the picture of clean clothes, and clean clothes help us to look smart as well. It is the next way by which we can maintain personal hygiene. Similarly, moving on to next point, that is, we should take proper care of our eyes, ears and nose. Now, can you tell me what kind of organs are eyes, ears, nose? We have different kinds of organs in our body, right? And some of the vital organs or some of the sensitive organs are also there. The eyes, our eyes, ears and nose are counted as our sense organs. How many sense organs are there altogether? Yes, you have already known the answer, right? There are altogether 5 sense organs, and among them, eyes, ears and nose are 3 of the sense organs. Since these organs are very vital, since they are very essential for us and they are very sensible in nature also, we must take care of these organs. How can we take care of our eyes? To take care of our eyes, we need to wash our face regularly and we need to splash clean and cold water in our eyes timely. Also, we should never rub our eyes. Do you have the habit of rubbing your eyes? If you have, then remove that habit, okay? We should never rub our eyes. And we should also never read in too bright or in too dim light also, and also in a moving vehicle. In a moving vehicle, when you try to focus on the letters written on your book or in the notebooks, it gets pressurized, our eyes gets pressurized, because the letters, they don't remain constant in a moving vehicle. So we must put an effort on our eyes so that it may harm our eyes. And we should never read in a too bright or in too dim light also. And if you get any infection regarding your eyes, then you must consult to the eye specialist very soon, okay? But you should not rub your eyes and you should not use any sort of medication without the permission of the doctor as well. Understood? Then, how can we take care of our nose? Okay. Nose, it can be cleaned with the help of clean handkerchief, or we can also use tissue papers to clean our nose. But the tissue papers and the handkerchief that we use to clean our nose must be clean as well as soft. And the handkerchief that is used by one person must not be used by the next one, because if certain person is suffering from any sort of infection, then other may also suffer from the same. So it should be used, it should be personal, it should be used by a single person only. Now, talking about next organ, that is ears. How can we take care of our ears? Ears, they should be cleaned with the help of clean cotton buds. They should be cleaned with the help of clean cotton buds, okay? We should not insert any sort of sharp instruments or sharp objects inside our ears or inside our nose also. In this way, we can take care of our eyes, nose and ears. Now students, let me take you to next way of maintaining personal hygiene. We should trim and clean our nails regularly. Okay, everyone, once check your nails, how long are they? Are they long? If they are long, then it's the time to trim your nails, okay? If they are short, then it's very good. And students, we must maintain our nails short. We must trim and cut our nails if they get long. Why should we trim our nails? We should trim our nails because if we do not trim our nails, then the dust and dirt gets stuck inside the nails. And whenever we eat food with the same hand, what happens? The germs or the dust gets inside our body, enters inside our body, and we may fall sick. We may suffer from various diseases as well. It leads to the growth of many harmful diseases, okay? And we should use nail cutter to trim our nails. Knives, blades, they are also sharp instruments, isn't it? They can also cut, but we should never use knives, blades to cut our nails. Instead, nail cutter must be used to cut our nails. See the picture, a baby's nails are being cut with the help of his guardians, right? And in the next picture, what you can see there is a girl is biting her nails. Do you also have the habit of biting your nails? I know you don't have, because you are good students, isn't it? And you must remember that we should never bite our nails. Okay? We have nail cutters to cut our nails, so why should we use our teeth to bite our nails, isn't it? Okay, so now taking to the next point of maintaining personal hygiene is we should wash our hands properly with clean water and soap before and after meal. Why is it so? Before and after meal. Before taking meal, if we do not wash our hands, then the germs that is in our hands, they enter inside our body along with the food. And the germs also get chance to develop inside our body. And we suffer from various diseases. That is why we should always wash our hands before taking meal. And after taking meal also, it's very necessary to wash our hands, because the same hand if we use for eating and without washing, if we use for doing other things, then what happens? The dirt gets transferred to many other places as well, isn't it? So we must wash our hands before and after taking meal. Now students, I want to take you to the last point, that is we should wash our hands after the use of toilets. Yes, every one of us, we do that, and we must do that as well. After we pass stool or urine in the toilets, then we must wash our hands with soap and water. And the latrine that we use must be covered. We should always use covered latrine. And we should never defecate in open places or in open lands, okay? What happens if we defecate in open places, then the germs and flies that sit on the excreta may move and sit on our food or other eatables also. And that also develops and that also increases the chance of causing many harmful diseases like dysentery, cholera, typhoid, etc. Okay, so it's very necessary to wash our hands after the use of toilet, and we should always use covered latrines. Okay, now students, these days what we are using the most, if we need to come out of our house, we wear mask, isn't it? And if we touch any other things, then we use sanitizer to sanitize our hands as well, isn't it? So use of mask and sanitizer is also a must. Okay, it is also a must. It is also one of the way to maintain personal hygiene, so that we can be protected from various diseases. Understood? So we discussed the ways of maintaining personal hygiene in today's class. What points did we learn? Can you revise it in short? Okay, let's recall it. Okay, the first point we went through, we should take a bath regularly, and we should use clean water and soap to take a bath. In the similar way, we should brush our teeth at least twice a day, and we should use good toothpaste and a soft toothbrush to brush our teeth. We should clean our hair regularly. We should wear clean clothes, and we should take proper care of our eyes, ears and nose. Also, we should trim and clean our nails, and we should use a nail cutter to trim our nails. We should wash our hands before and after taking meal. Also, we should wash our hands after the use of toilets, and we should use mask and sanitizer to sanitize our hands. Okay, and maintaining personal hygiene help us to prevent from various diseases, and it also helps to build our personality. So I hope everyone we will maintain personal hygiene. We are maintaining and we will maintain personal hygiene. Okay. Students, expecting this much for today, expecting your presence in other classes, in other new topics as well, I want to end today's class. Thank you, everyone.